kept on for about 6 years. Totally fine. Thinking back on it 20 years later, it's still worth it. Before I was due to go on vacation, the head office decided to apply.
Shovel labor to dig out that pipe and replace it with a new one.
for a fraction of that price. But no, they had to have a giant Caterpillar type machine do it. They called, but then handed them a Xerox copy of a letter that their lawyers had sent us, with a pursuant to paragraph, blah blah, on the code, blah blah blah, citing the next paragraph, which stated that the person using the easement was 100% responsible for any damage to the
I'm still on the ground. I just want to know that if I can hear you and I'm wearing
extremely loudly. She then says, in a voice loud enough for me to hear, where is the cat food? There's a man behind her who was socially distancing until she raised her voice. I can see him approach quickly. He doesn't work there either, and I can hear him literally yell at her. He's saying, hey lady, don't touch her. What's wrong with you? So this attracts the attention of nearby people. Thankfully, two people who actually work there. I can see the blue shirts coming, and I just skirt back from the lady as she turns away from me and starts bickering with the man. Now, I can't hear most of it, but I can definitely see it escalating. I stand up, step back further, and brush myself off. I pick up my sandwich meat, but the bread is a lost cause. One employee clearly tries to de-escalate the situation, and she's just shrill and gesturing madly. I can no longer hear the man because he hasn't raised his voice anymore. One of the staff is now standing beside me, and I think she's asking me if I'm okay. I just shrug, throw up a few signs that says, I'm deaf. Sorry, I don't know her. And I point aggressively at the lady who scared me. The man is explaining everything that happened to the other staff member. The second employee seems to understand that I'm deaf and just nods. She motions for me to step back further from the argument, and I do. She then puts herself between myself and the small crowd of people. There's a brief discussion. The employee shaking his head, some of which I can hear and some of which I can't. Something about never again. The lady is actually escorted from the store, her car left behind, and I was super surprised by that. When all is said and done, things quiet down. The customer who intervened points at me and flashes the okay symbol that most people know is to point their finger to thumb with the three fingers out. I smiled and nodded and signed and loudly said, thank you, before the Walmart employee led me back to the area to get new bread. I flashed the man the peace sign before I left.
Anywhere.
I signed thank you again before he went away. Guys, what a crazy encounter. Like dealing with a crazy parent when you're up hearing a parent is already a bad situation. But an OP situation was not the employee. He has autism. The man then looks at the mom with narrowed eyes and says, don't. It doesn't take kindly to someone being treated badly, especially if it's a person with disability, as his younger son has autism. Oscar looks at the customer with a dad glare and says, sir, I'm going to have to ask you to watch your language and your actions. I can verify that these are a pair of guests and that he was rearranging the shelves because he wanted to. And even if they did work here, that doesn't give you the right to harass them. Just then, security walks over, apparently attracted by the commotion. And George goes from tomato red to dead cheek white. Oscar then turns to the mother and says, ma'am, if you want to press charges, we can help you. The mom was put away. Guys, I just want to say that that man should have been arrested and charged. And I'm upset that nothing happened. It just breaks my heart, reading about the man harassing the kid. Well, the mom was just in tears trying to defend her son. All I can say is Oscar was a lot calmer than I would have been. If I were not to choose, I might have lost my job that day, guys. Like, harassing a clearly terrified kid, and then having the audacity to throw the armor around. Oh boy, I'd be swinging. So this story happened around 10 years ago. Some important background. My mom was paralyzed from the waist down, so my dad and I would take her grocery shopping every now and then. She had a motorized wheelchair, but it was too bulky to take with us to the store, so we brought her non-motorized wheelchair with us. One of those push-outs, hey, leave my daughter alone. My dad's voice was loud enough to get an employee to rush over. The employee asked if there's a problem, and my dad said, this woman just assaulted my daughter. Do you have a first aid kit or something to help her out? Because I'm going to call the cops while you get on this. Upon hearing the word cops, the lady just sunk to the floor crying and trying to say it was just a misunderstanding. When the cops arrived, I'd been bandaged up. The manager had come to listen to mine and my dad's story, as well as the employee describing the aftermath. And they went to the back with the manager to check the video. Meanwhile, the lady was crying and saying, I'll lose my kids. The cops arrested her for assault on a minor. At the time, and that she did indeed lose custody of her kids. I think the father thought it. She even tried to say it was an honest mistake. I thought she was an employee. Whereupon the judge says, even if she was an employee, what gives you the right to grab someone like that? The woman broke into more tears as the judge gave her sentence. Guys, all she had to do was keep her hands to herself, and she couldn't. Like, whatever happened, excuse me, can you help me find this item? Oh! You don't work here? I thought you were an employee. Let me just go on with my day. But no, she just had to grab Ruby's arm and nuke her own life. Guys, maybe it's a good thing she got her kids taken away. I don't know.
The tone and texture, her back.
Okay, so the end result of this story, which I'll tell you up front, is that we lost the ability to order those several local pizza ovens for a flight. Let me tell you why. So we used to have a phone number of those very similar to pizza ovens. Their number was 555-455-5575. And our number was 555-455-5515. Now these two numbers are commonly mixed up for obvious reasons. And this was back before the day was done, and everyone having their phone number was for an advertisement on paper, billboard, and the phone book. And guess what? They lost the numbers and put our number on the things for the phone number. Why? Because 1 and 7s are the same number, apparently. So our phone epic explodes. It goes from 3 to 5 phone calls a day to like 100 to 200 calls. Initially, we were directing people with a message that simply said, "This is not Pizza Hut. Their number is this, this, this." And it didn't end. We would get calls with people screaming into the voice recording, "I want an effing pizza. This is BS. I'm going to kill whoever doesn't answer this effing phone." Now, I can't tell you how many times I've been told to go jump off the bridge for trying to direct someone to the correct place. And for some effing reason, no one ever listens. Well, upon this happening, my dad calls the Pizza Hut and says, "Look, all we want is to not have to change our phone numbers. If you guys will please change yours or pay for ours to be changed, we'll stop you the oblivious to this fact." Again, the manager screams at dad saying, "I don't have money to change your effing number." We even tried calling other Pizza Huts to get the issue resolved, with no real luck. So we fielded phone calls every day, all day long. We had friends come over, and they loved partaking in the same thing. We had a general plan. Every other call would get a pizza delivery, and the other calls, we would get them really pissed off, say, "Okay, do you want to speak to my manager?" And then cold transfer them to the Pizza Hut. It took 6 more weeks of us doing this, and the Pizza Hut closed. A few weeks before they closed, we get a phone call from Pizza Hut corporate, who more or less threatened us with a cease and desist. And it sounded like they didn't really understand what was actually happening, as they accused us of stealing their phone calls. We called their corporate and explained what was going on, and even played our recordings of talking with them about the issue and them ignoring us. All they said is, "You better stop. This is illegal," over and over again. And we didn't stop. A few weeks after the owner lost his job, he called our house and was trying to argue with my dad about how bad of a person he was because he lost money. Apparently, we had also pissed people off to the point that they actually went in and attacked him and the other staff. To this day, it cracks me up that a company can be so oblivious, and it's the single reason that I don't believe, and then calls 911 when OP defends herself. It's such a crazy story, so go check it out if you haven't, and myself and Stevie Boy, we'll see you guys in the next one. Love you.
For 2 men in a truck, it feels like rough. How about getting out there, helping people? Hard work doesn't feel like hard work. And even though you don't do it for the 5-star reviews, you get them anyway. That's why you work for 2 men in a truck.
So here we are, outside of our house, watching firefighters try to save it, when I noticed my next-door neighbor, who my family didn't like, filming the whole thing. Now back then, I still lived at home, and we lived in a small village where everybody knows their neighbors. So I knew who this was, and I decided to confront him. I walk over to him and ask why he thought it was okay to film this. He first gave me some stupid reason, how this was a one-time occurrence, and how he'd never seen a burning building before, and he wanted to show it to his friends. But then, he starts telling me how traumatizing this whole thing was to him, his wife, and his kids in detail. He told me how they probably never feel safe again living next to our house, how terrible it was that they built that. So a couple of weeks ago, I opted out for going out to couch. I of course offered to watch my little cousin. I loved him and it was awesome. So we messed around the house for a little bit, playing his Xbox. After lunch, he tells me that he wants to go sledge. I call my aunt and she said it was fine. So near the school, there's a huge pile of dirt. And when it builds up in the window, there's a pot guys in general, and it's a fun place. We slide down a few times, and we have lots of fun. So enter the entitled mom, and her kids don't get kids, and we drink some hot cocoa and take a break. It was at this point the mom pushes her kid down the slide. The kid leans towards the side in the middle of riding and tries to hit people who are walking across the hill. Thankfully, they all carefully walk out of the way, and nothing bad happens. I say to her, hey, can you please watch your kid? I think he's purposely trying to hurt other people. Now, hearing this, the Karen gives me a dirty look and basically tells me it's a line of no business. I go back to my cousin and let a mom go to the local drinks his cocoa. At the top of the hill, I can see the mom saying something to the kid. And out of nowhere, she pushes her son's sled. The kid then changes course towards me and my little cousin. This time, I was fast. I moved my cousin and then pushed the kid away, causing him to flip over and wipe out. The kid then cries really loud, and of course the mom storms down the hill and begins to scream at me. And she's angry. She's screaming, "You effing idiot! You could have killed him! You're an effing worthless piece of crap!" I say to her, "You were the one who pushed your kid directly at us, using your kid to injure others." The mom proceeds to call me many, many curse words that I don't feel like writing out. At this point, my little cousin's shaking with tears rolling down his face, and I decide to get up and leave. The mom's screaming at me to get the F back here because she's not done with me. So I flip her off and pack my cousin into the car. Later that evening, I found out from some neighbors that this wasn't the first time she tried to pull that crap. Neighbors told me that her and her kid often get a good kick out of it, and she deliberately tells her kid to try to hit people. Now, I wish I could say there was a happy ending here, but this woman can put me to life in prison or something else, but there's not. Sometimes I see her walking around the neighborhood, and I try to avoid her. So yeah, I think the neighborhood needs to get together to stop this irresponsible caricat before her son seriously injures himself or hurts others. Like, this is something that's worth getting police involved in, or are we dealing with... Okay, so I work at a grocery store, and it was a pretty slow day today. I was super bored and had like 2 hours left in my shift, so I was wandering around and looking for my friend, who's also my coworker. So right as I was rounding the corner to the produce section, I hear people arguing near the winery, and also a crying baby. So me being curious and bored, I decide to check it out. Well, it turns out it was my friend, and he was arguing with this woman with an oversized baby bag and a stroller. With what looked to be a pretty irritated item. She then starts to get irate. I tell her, "Ma'am, you need to return these wine bottles because you're stealing from the store." The lady screams, "No!" Which at this point, my friend tells her, "Yeah, you need to give those back. I caught you in your attempt to steal them, and you need to put them back. We will have to call police if you refuse." Now, what she says next still baffles me to this day. The Karen says, "I'm a taxpaying citizen. Which means I basically own this store. You wouldn't have jobs without me." At this point, the situation was escalating way too fast, and other people were beginning to look at us. Eventually, my manager comes out to see what's up. My friend and I were in the middle of explaining the situation, and the lady just keeps off running. She left her stroller behind. My manager radios the store security, and they stopped her at the entrance. And I had to push the stroller so the cars were keeping her. When the crazy woman realized that she wasn't going to get away, she then takes one of the bottles in her bag and throws it at my manager. It nearly missed his hat. It was pretty bad. And then the security guards tried to tackle her and stop her from getting out another bottle. One of my coworkers called police, and my manager was screaming to the lady. I don't know if he'll be pressing charges against her enough. I was put in charge of taking the wine bottle. She had no idea that she was this unhinged. The woman was arrested for shoplifting and attempted assault with a deadly weapon. My manager is pressing charges for emotional distress. CPS let the mom keep the baby, but I'm pretty sure they might be conducting a search on the baby's living conditions. My friend and I were also reprimanded for confronting a shoplifter, because that does go against store policy. So yeah, that's pretty much what happened. So I'm a musician in a wedding band, and as such, you expect the odd bridezilla now and again. But this particular occasion managed to be a lovely crossover between an entitled parent and an entitled bride. Hold on to your butts. So basically, I don't know what weddings are like in other parts of the world, but here in the UK, about 8 p.m, everybody makes their way to the main hall. They then take a seat for the bride and groom dancer and begin to attend. Now, I had a few email conversations back and forth with the bride before that. I spoke to her in person, and we set up and we were good to go. She seemed a bit stuck up though, but normally, I just put it down to them being a little nervous, or in some cases, impressive kids. So how was she stuck up? Well, I introduced myself, clearly extended my hand to her to shake it, and she basically looked at my hand, ignored it, and went back to talking with one of her bridesmaids. I then waited for a gap in their conversation and said, "Hi, just to let you know that it's good to go for the first dance at 8. I'm looking forward to it." The bride then turns around to me and said, "Eh, can't you see I'm busy? Go away and do your job. That's what I've paid you for." So yeah, she's a bitch. That's fine. I've dealt with horrible brides before. I couldn't spy the groom anywhere, so I did exactly what she said and buggered off for a while. So 8 p.m. rolls around, we're on stage waiting for everybody to pile into the room. About 10 minutes later, we get the thumbs up from the wedding coordinator to announce them into the room. I announce them in, "Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the dance floor for their first dance as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. blah blah blah." Everyone's clapping, they walk in, but the bride looks fuming. She marches right up to me and says, "I wanted you to announce us as the blah blahs, so do it." I smiled, apologized, and tried not to let it bother me, saying, "Ladies and gentlemen, give them a big round of applause as they take to the dance floor, the blah blahs." The bride then glared at me like I just hunted a new boy, and she stomped to the dance floor. So by now, you've got a decent idea of what kind of person I'm dealing with here. Very rude, a control freak, and not lovely at all. So we get stuck into the first dance, and the song is perfect by Ed Sheeran. So original. There's videographers, photographers, and about 200 people there. So as you can imagine, the most coming down, this dance is the main part of the night that you simply have to get right. Now it's pretty stressful, but as long as you're confident and know the song, you're golden. That is, unless the bride snuck those infant decides that it's time to enter your life. So this kid appears out of nowhere, and he starts running around the bride and groom. He's just above knee height, so, I don't know, maybe he's 3 years old? For some reason, he's carrying some sort of a stick with a ball on the end of it, kind of like a wizard's wand. They're laughing. Everybody thinks it's funny and cute. Ha ha, great. And then the kid decides it would be a great idea to abandon the boat, and while we're performing the most important song of the evening, he happily runs up to the drum kit and starts smashing the cymbals while my drummer is trying to play the effing song. Now, cymbals are very expensive. They don't appreciate being hammered by things that aren't drumsticks. Anyway, I'm just saying away, trying to ignore it and assuming that someone, anyone, will come and collect the kit. An auntie, an uncle, a grandparent. No, that would be the logical thing to do, but nobody comes out. I'm trying to sing the song, and just at the second chorus, all you can hear is